In this video, I'll be doing a short demonstration on the new Artisan Shibui plugin, which is essentially a stripped down and less cluttered version of the Artisan Max plugin, but where Artisan Max combines all features of the Artisan Pro and Quickmask Pro plugin, plus a few more only available in Artisan Max. Artisan Shibui only contains the most important and most used features of Artisan Pro and almost all features of Quickmask Pro. Therefore, I think it's less cluttered, clearer, and even more efficient than Artisan Max. So in this demo, I'm going to use a few masking features of the plugin that are obviously also available in Artisan Max, Artisan Pro, and Quickmask Pro. So there's nothing new here, but it's always good to do a few more demonstrations with the new panel, and also with a few features that are also available in Artisan Pro and Quickmask Pro. So here we go. So let's get started. I have here an image of some reed in the water with some dense fog in the background. Of course, I want to make this a black and white fine art image. And for that, I need to isolate the reed and isolate the rest of the background. So basically two selections, two masks. So how can we do that? First of all, I'm going to try that with Adobe Photoshop's subject detection tool. So I go to select and then subject, and then see the marching ants. You save that selection, call it PS subject. Okay, let's see how it looks like. So if you have a look at it, you see that it's lacking all sorts of details. It's a very poor mask, to say the least. All right, so let's go try the other option, that is Photoshop object detection tool. So that is this one. So you just select roughly the area that you want to mask, which is this part. So then Photoshop makes a selection of that. So that's that. Then I'm going to save it, call it PS object detection. So let's have a look at that. So you see that the object detection tool does a slightly better job in terms of details. So this is the subject detection tool. This is the object detection tool. And you see that especially here, there are some more details compared to the subject detection. So that is still not good enough. So what I'm going to try to do is to use my new Artisan Shibui panel, which, like I stated already, is a combination of Artisan Pro and Quickmask Pro, using almost all features of Quickmask Pro and only the most important features of Artisan Pro. So basically the same as Artisan Max, but then more streamlined, stripped down, less cluttered, and just simply, I think, better and more clearer. So what I'm going to do is to just use the manual subject detect. I'm just going to indicate what I want to have selected. So this part. Okay, and then I say manual subject detect. I go with low key and partial blending. So these are the options that you have in the Artisan Shibui panel, the same as in the Quickmask Pro panel. I'm not going to explain that, because for that, just have a look at the Quickmask Pro videos or the Artisan Max video, in which I explain what you can do with all the different masking features that are in the panels. So I go with low key. It takes a few seconds to do that. Okay, then you have three new channel masks, and you just pick the right one that will do for you. And I think that I'm going to go with this one. So I'm just going to get rid of the rest. And you see that it selected more than with Adobe Photoshop's object detection tool, but it's a good starting point, especially if you look here. This is with the panel. See, it has more detail than the one with Photoshop Object Detection Tool. But I can make it much better. So for that, you have the Advanced Refine in the Artisan Shibui panel. Also in the Artisan Max and the Quickness Pro panel. I go with Low Key because that was my starting point. So I always choose the same zone as the zone that you choose to create the mask. And that, in this case, that was the Low Key. I can also go with the Adjacent Zone, but I just start with the Low Key zone. I click on Create Low Key Temporary Files. So they are created, so don't look at those temporary files or channels. Just go straight here. They are just temporary files that will support the use of that specific feature. I'm going to select this area that I want to refine. And then I say, okay, make it a little bit darker and more detailed. So after one pass, I already have this. And you can see that the result is much more detailed than this one by Photoshop, let alone this one with the subject detection tool. So this one I have, I can make it even better. So I'm just going to do it again. And now I'm saying, okay, just give me a little bit more white. Okay. And then make it darker again. So now I'm not going to go with 4, but with 3 or maybe 2. Let's try 2. Just a little bit darker. So now I have my mask. I can get rid of the temporary files. So I have this by Photoshop, this also by Photoshop, and this is my result, which I think you should agree with is much better than the results by Photoshop. So now I can duplicate that channel, invert it, then call it background. And I'm gonna rename this and call it read. So I have the read and I have the background. I can get rid of those by Photoshop. So now I have my two masks, one of the read, one of the background. So now I can start working with the black and white conversion and then the adjustments. So in the Artisan Shibui panel, just go to conversions. The same for Artisan Max, you just go to conversions. And if you have the Artisan Pro panel, you do basically the same. So they're all available in the other two panels as well. So here I'm going to go with the neutrals conversion. And now I want to lighten this part a little bit. And now, you know what? I'm just going to select the entire background. And I want to lighten it. And the way that I'm going to go about it is with creating depth from top to bottom. And then lighten it. Okay, so I've lightened it. And now I can do a restore from the bottom up. This is all explained in other videos on YouTube. Just look them up. So this is my first pass. Just lighten it. And now I want to lighten this part a little bit on the over here and over here. So for that, I'm gonna load that selection again, the background. But now I'm gonna subtract with my marquee tool and say, okay, I want to subtract this part. I'm going to go with lighten from left to right. So let me do that, left to right, with the small one, strength of 2. Okay, so now you have this. Then of course you have to do the restore there. So let me go do that with a small, all right. Now doing the same from the right hand side. Lighten, small, then also restore a little bit more. Okay, so now I have this. lighten the sides. Let's merge it left and right. Okay, so now what I want to do is to lighten this area specifically over here and darken the top part just a little bit more. So let me load the selection of the background again. And now I'm saying, okay, darken it from the top down. This top to bottom. Let me go with stronger. Oh, I have to make sure that I've selected that, of course. Top to bottom. All right. So it's much darker, so now I have to do a large restore. And a little bit more. Okay. Now only the top part has been darkened, and now I want to lighten this again, the midsection. So I'm going to grab my marquee tool. So I want to lighten that part. Something like that. And I'm, well, just a little bit more. So just starting up a little bit higher. Like that. Then I'm going to use my background selection, intersect that, because I don't want this part to be included. Okay, now I have to save that selection, temp 1, so then it will be saved here. Okay, so now I can lighten it, and the way that I'm going to do that is with I think I'm going to go with the gradient depth from bottom to top. Okay, now do a restore. Let me see that. Yeah, I'm going to do a restore. So, all right, now I'm just going to do this. A little bit from the right, a little bit from the left and from the right. Let me see what I have now. Okay, and a little bit more to restore. So just like so. Okay. Something like this. All right. Now I want to make the reed and the water just a little bit darker. So for that, first I'm going to use the selection of the reed. Like so. And then I'm I think I'm going to need some luminosity mask as well. So let me deselect it first. I'm going to create some luminosity mask. Some darker luminosity mask, always from the background, the original background layer. I'm going to use 375, so duplicate that, and then just get rid of the rest. So here, I'm going to use a new layer, because if you do that with the Pro adjustments, it won't create a new layer automatically. I'm going to load the read and then load it together with the docs 375, intersect that, and then adjustments, Pro adjustments, same in the Artisan Max, also in the Artisan Pro. But then you have to look it up in under Pro Tools, I think. Off the top of my head, I'm going to use selective adjustments, darken it. Okay, as before, after, I don't need to do a restore because it's already has a very subtle kind of edge. And now I want to do this as well, also darken it. So let me go select this part, and then select it with the background, so that the read won't be included. So intersect that. All right, and then I'm gonna save. Well, I don't need to do that. I just create a new layer first, and then just to make sure, I'm just gonna save that selection tab to. Now intersect the dark 375 luminosity mask, intersect. Okay, and now I can darken it as well. Okay, I darken that too, but I'm gonna use the restore. Go to depth, then this a little bit stronger. Okay. So just darken the water a little bit, and you can do so much more, but I'll leave it at this. It was just a short demonstration of the new Artisan Shibui panel, how to mask it, and how to use a different kind of tools, combination with the mask and the features in the panel. And lastly, what I want to do is to add a little bit of toning. So if you compare the color section with the split toning, if you compare it with Artisan Pro or Artisan Max, then it doesn't have all the complicated split tone features, just the most basic split tone features like basic toning and split toning music, and they're the most used split tones in the panel. There's no color grading because that's not needed here, so I go with the Into the Mystic. A little bit stronger, like so. There we have it. So this is the final image. So I started off from here, and I ended with this. Okay, thank you for watching.